you could turn around and sell your home the next day, but why would you do that? No one's making you stay, obviously, but selling your home immediately after buying it can mean that you could lose money, face capital gains tax, and also incur penalties in paying off that mortgage right away. Those are called mortgage penalties. This is Kiwi the Coast, your luxury real estate specialist, helping you sell and maximize the value of your coastal home. So let's dive into this one. So how soon after buying a home can you sell it without losing money? Technically, you're free to sell a home anytime after purchasing it, but is it a smart financial move? Let's look at point number one. That's the benefits to selling fast. Look, sometimes there's real financial benefits in turning a house quickly and taking your profits. Let's look at some of them now. So here are a few instances. For example, let's say you bought this home as a flipper, you've made substantial improvements, the value has increased, and you want to take your profit. Or sometimes in a neighborhood, values have shot up unexpectedly. Perhaps some neighbors have sold for a new record in the area just recently. Or builders have come in, changing the complexion of the neighborhood and building new product valued higher than the home you bought. Or perhaps you got a good deal initially, you know, buying at a foreclosure, distressed sale, or even a short sale, and so you want to take your profit now while you've got the chance. Second point I want to make is, make sure you subtract from your price that you're selling at all the costs that you incurred in buying the home, but also selling it. Now, what are these? Let's look at the buyer closing costs, shall we? Usually less than seller closing costs, but they can be anywhere from 1% to 5% of the purchase price, depending on how those costs are negotiated. Some of those, for instances, are your escrow fees or your settlement fees, also costs in obtaining the loan, the appraisal, and so on. If we look at the seller closing costs, these are usually a little higher just because of how deals are negotiated, and a seller is likely to incur greater costs, somewhere between 6 to 10%, depending on the transaction. The biggest of those costs is, of course, the real estate commissions. Typically, the seller is paying for the listing side commissions as well as the buyer side commissions, sometimes in the order of between 5 and 6%. He's also got escrow fees, title fees to guarantee clear title to the property, unless it's negotiated otherwise. Also, that it can be the cost of repairs, termites, fumigation if you're in California, that can add to that list. So that means if you're selling a house in California, let's say for around $1 million, you could incur costs of between $60,000 and $100,000 on that transaction, depending on how it's set up. Now, seller can also incur some additional charges, typically the transfer tax that a state is going to charge here in California or Orange County. That's $1.10 per thousand. Also, there's prorations for depending on when you close, prorated costs such as HOA or homeowners association dues and assessments. Sometimes there's more than one. You've also got property tax prorations. If an owner has paid his property tax through the end of the year, he's liable to get some of that back at the closing table. But if he hasn't, then that's an additional cost in closing that needs to be taken into account. Third point is to analyze the capital gains. Now, if you've lived in your home as a primary residence for the last 2 years, then you can claim $500,000 tax-free if you're married, $250,000 if you're single, and that money, that capital gains from when you bought the home to what you're selling it for, less costs, is tax-free. Now, another rule is, if you've lived in that home for 2 of the last 5 years, that also applies. You've only got to live there 2 of the last 5 years for that $500,000 and $250,000 exemption to exist. But if you're selling quickly and selling earlier than 2 years, then you've got to look at what those capital gains costs are going to be. Sometimes you're exempt from paying those capital gains. For example, natural disaster, loss of employment, or even death of a family member. But remember, anytime you've got capital gains related questions, that's a tax implication. Always contact your tax advisor, aka accountant. Hey, I hope you found all that information valuable, and we'll see you on the next video. Vroom!